The purpose of this lab is to determine the physical and chemical properties of organic compounds. Majority of organic compounds are made of carbon and hydrogen, and a few contain nitrogen, oxygen, phosphorus, and sulfur along with carbon and hydrogen. We can use the mnemonics CHNOPS to represent the elements of organic compounds. An inorganic compound is typically a chemical compound that lacks carbon to hydrogen bond, means a compound that is not an organic compound. This table represents the difference between organic and inorganic compounds. Organic compounds are formed by covalent bonds. Inorganic compounds are formed by ionic bonds. Organic compounds are soluble in non-polar solvents, whereas inorganic compounds are soluble in polar solvents like water. Organic compounds have low melting and boiling points. Inorganic compounds have high melting and boiling points. Organic compounds are characterized with a strong or distinct odor. Inorganic compounds generally do not have any odor. Organic compounds are poor conductors of electricity. Inorganic compounds are good conductors of electricity. First part of this lab, we compare the physical properties of few organic and inorganic compounds. To determine the physical properties, we compare the color, odor, and physical states of these chemicals. Sodium chloride is a white crystalline salt. Cyclohexane is a colorless liquid with a peculiar odor. Potassium iodide is a white crystalline solid. Benzoic acid is white crystalline salt. Water is a colorless, odorless liquid. Toluene is a colorless liquid with a peculiar odor. Most inorganic compounds are ionic and soluble in water, a polar solvent. Sodium chloride dissolves completely in water. Sodium chloride is not soluble in cyclohexane. Cyclohexane is an organic solvent. Organic compounds are typically non-polar and thus are not soluble in water. They are soluble in organic solvents as they are both non-polar. The general rules of solubility is like dissolves like. Toluene is not soluble in water. You can see the two layers. It is insoluble. Whereas toluene is completely soluble in cyclohexane. Hydrocarbons are organic compounds composed of carbon and hydrogen only. They may be aliphatic hydrocarbons or aromatic hydrocarbons. Aliphatic hydrocarbons are divided into three main groups according to the types of bonds they contain. Alkanes are also called saturated hydrocarbons since it contains only single bonded carbon and hydrogen atoms, and the compound names ends with ANE. Alkenes and alkynes are called unsaturated hydrocarbons. Alkenes have at least one double bond, and the compound names ends with ene. Alkynes have at least one triple bond, and the compound names ends with yne. Members of the aromatic hydrocarbons family have a ring of six carbon atoms and alternating double and single bonds. To find the reactivity of hydrocarbons, we will do bromine test. Reaction of bromine with an alkene is an example of addition reaction. When bromine reacts with an alkene, the yellowish orange color of the bromine disappears. Reaction of bromine with an alkane is a very slow reaction and requires light. And aromatic compounds are not reactive with the bromine. For reaction with the bromine, we use hexane, cyclohexene, toluene, and three unknowns, unknown A, B, and C solutions. Place 15 drops of hexane, cyclohexene, toluene, and the three unknowns in a test tube. After adding 15 drops of hydrocarbons and the unknown solutions, add 3 or 4 drops of 1% bromine in dichloromethylene. Cyclohexene at a test tube gives a positive result for bromine. Unknown B at a test tube gives positive result for bromine. In this test, potassium permanganate reacts with an alkene but not with alkane or aromatic compounds. Purple color of the permanganate changes to brown manganese dioxide and a diol in the presence of an alkene. Place 15 drops of hexane, cyclohexene, toluene, and the three unknowns in a test tube. After adding 15 drops of hydrocarbons and the unknown solutions, next add 5 drops of 1% potassium permanganate into each tube and record the color change. A positive test for an unsaturated compound is a change in color from purple to brown. Cyclohexene added tube change into brown. And unknown B also change into brown. Confirms the presence of alkene. These results confirms that bromine and potassium permanganate readily reacts with an alkene or an unsaturated hydrocarbon, but not with an alkane or aromatic hydrocarbon.